Welcome back, bowling fans. This week in the draft league, week 6 or 18 overall, this is the most exciting 15 minutes in sports entertainment on the number one bowling show on the internet today. Unfortunately, we have to start off 2020 on a somber note. The bowling community lost one of its own. Tommy Malagreca, in a tragic accident 2 days ago, passed away. And we are very sad about this. Tommy was life of the party, always smiling, always laughing. In fact, we referenced him on the show a few times when we were talking about Tommy wheeling in the 10-ball roller. Tommy needed a forklift to get his equipment into the center. You never know what condition they're going to put out. Always prepared, Tommy Malagreca. So when the bowling community loses one of its own, it's a sad day. So my condolences go out to Tommy's family, and the condolences of the whole entire bowling community behind me go out to him and his family. You know what? Let's dedicate every strike thrown tonight dedicated to Tommy Malagreca. So we're saddened today. With that, I know Tommy loved the show, and he laughed his ass off. First up, on camera number one, this man just shot 768 a couple of days ago. Many people say, how? I don't say that. Powder says, how? I don't know. Right, Powder? 768. He's none other than the Middle East Machete, Matt Kaplowitz. Matt, you better send some emails home to put the switch on for the Iron Dome. Because right now, tensions are high in the Middle East. And when they get pissed off, they just usually send a missile for no reason into the homeland. Iron Dome on. Second up, I was with this man Saturday night, and we walked in that place, Mizu, like Henry Hill at the Copa.
That's right. Every time I come here, you two.
Exactly. Also known as Mr. Saturday Night, Kenny Soto. Come on in, Scotty Walsh. Last but not least. Come on, Scott. Let's go. Come on. Let's hustle it up. Go back there with Vito. Let's hustle it up. Last but not least, Brooklyn Zone, Staten Island Zone, on a somber note today. Joe Cal, what do we got? Tommy Malagreca, not here with us anymore.
You know what, Joe? Very saddened. We actually heard about that Saturday night as we were wrapping up dinner. The Facebook messages started pouring in about Tommy. So Tommy was definitely one of the nicest guys, a gentleman. He always greeted you with that smile that he had from, he always, that ear-to-ear smile. Tommy could light up a room. The wake is Wednesday, 2 to 4 and 7 to 9 at Padel Pizzo out on Amboy Road, way out there. Tommy would light up a room and always laughing, always wanted everyone around him to be laughing. Even if the joke was on him, he was always out there laughing it up, making sure everybody was having fun. And you know what? Tommy always, kind of like Spallone, always dressed the part, slacks or khakis, a bowling shirt, a golf shirt. Tommy always with the collared shirt, always dressed to the nines. He treated the game right. He treated his opponents right, respected the house. Tommy was a gentleman through and through. And our condolences to the Malagreca family. DSNY, he was a Vietnam vet. DSNY, he was going to retire in a couple of years. Tommy was actually if I'm not mistaken, he was voted Sanitation Man of the Year just not too long ago for 2019. So everybody loved Tommy. The guys in his garage, everybody, his friends. And again, condolences to his family. It's a terrible loss. The bowling community is definitely mourning. So we're going to try to get through the show tonight. But like Joe said, we're going to dedicate it to our boy Tommy. Tommy, my boy, like he used to call everybody, my boy. So rest in peace, Tom. You sleep easy, brother. But on that note, I'm going to bring in our guest tonight. Okay, we thought we had one guest. We have Vito Collucci, and we got Scott Walsh, last second appearance. Come on in. Come on in, guys. Joe Bruno said, I'm not kidding, Scott. You can ask Vito. He'll back me up, right? Joe Bruno said, we should have got Walsh tonight. We got Walsh tonight, and we got Vito. Vito, you come on this side. So now I got to think of some off-the-cuff questions to ask Scott. But this is good. We're gonna do things on the fly. I had Vito's questions all lined up. I'll come back to you, Scott, in a second. So, Vito, the bowling community wants to know, when did you first start bowling?
I was about 18 years old.
Okay.
I don't remember the exact year. I started 18, bowling on the green. Took a break for like 14 years.
Okay.
This is my summer league, first league back.
Right. And you know what? I had the pleasure of bowling against Vito and Scott during the summer, and I was happy to hear that Vito was going to join the league and Scott was coming into the league. So what is it, what drew you, besides Scott saying, do you want to bowl, what drew you to come bowl in our league? What was the allure of coming into the draft league?
Well, I've always liked bowling, and I was always half decent.
Right.
So when I started coming back in on the triples league, I was feeling it a little bit.
Yeah,
started doing okay.
Yeah.
I always like competition, so I heard this was the best. I want to bowl with the best, like you, Joe. Yeah.
Well, the best is not me, but I appreciate it. I'm far from the best, man. Maybe 30 years ago. But Scott, what was the allure for you to come into the draft league?
Well, I wanted to bowl in a better league, and I couldn't do that because of my job changed hours. So I had to come to what I could do, you know, best I could do, and I wanted to bowl with good bowls. So that was the idea.
Well, we appreciate having both of you guys. So, when did you first start bowling, Scott?
Well, I believe it. I started bowling in, bowling on green was, I'm trying to think, before the sports bubble, before that. It was like probably when I was about 12, 13, something like that.
Yeah.
I bowled, yeah. And I used to bowl in the old league here, in the young league, and all the popular guys were here. It was the junior league. I don't know.
Penro?
Back in the day, it was like probably in this 80s.
Was it Penro?
It was when Dukes of Hazzard was on.
Oh, Dukes of Hazzard. That's tell you how old I am. I think I was married when Dukes of Hazzard was on. That's how long I've been around. Who invited him anyway? He's making me feel old. Vito, who invited him? Nah, it's okay. So, Scott, what was your first ball?
I believe it or not, it actually was a plastic ball. White dot.
White dot.
And that was when I bowled it from the corner. No, I had no hook. I had no hook. I threw it straight from the corner.
Really?
Yeah.
Everybody had a white dot back then. Vito, you remember your first ball?
I actually do, because believe it or not, I got off the rack. It was a blue.
Really?
It was a blue hammer.
The blue hammer?
Good ball back then. So,
Well, if you know what? That was probably when the company Fayball owned Hammer. Way back. It's going back to the 80s, right?
Well, not the 80s, but maybe like the 97, somewhere around that.
I think Fayball still owned it back then before Ebonite took it over. Fayball, remember that, Joe? So we want to know, not to put anybody on the spot, but do you like your team better from the first third, or are you happy with your team this third? We're not putting them on the spot.
Not on the spot, but the first one was good. I feel like I click more with this team now, but yeah. I got the girl Brittany Pace to get Brian Deloise. We got some good bowlers.
He's bowling with Brittany Pace. I won the league with Brittany the first third. So, Vito, I think you're in good hands.
I think I'm in good hands, too. No complaints right now.
Well, listen, Matt, no comments from the peanut gallery. Just do your job on camera. Scott, do you like your who did you have the first third?
Ed Fernan and I forget his name. Young kid, rookie. Kind of guy. I don't know his name.
Nick LaRocca?
I think so. I took some.
Yeah. Okay. And who are you with this third?
I have Juan Benitez, and I have I think the other guy's name. I forget the other guy's name, but
who's the other bowler on Benitez's team?
I don't know.
He comes from Long Island. I know he comes from Long Island.
Oh, Jimmy Barotti. Jimmy, my friend, the drawbridge was stuck.
When he bowls against us,
just a funny story. A year ago, Jimmy was he was in a slump for a couple of weeks. He bowled against me. So of course, like Joe says, Jimmy Barotti became Joe Barotti, the old PBA star. He had like the front seven, and I said, Jimmy, got an alert on my phone. The drawbridge is up in Marine Park. You're not going to get home unless you leave now. So get out of here. I don't know if I shook him up, but I think he threw a split on the next shot. But we love you, Jim. We're just kidding. So, Joe, you want to come in? You got some questions for these fine guys? Scott, thanks for making a last-second appearance. Vito, you are the man. Thank you, man. Thank you. Joe B., all yours.
Thank you, Joe. And what's up, Scott? What's up, Vito? Yeah, so these two guys, I do remember when they were youngsters at the green, bowling on the green for those of you little people, little bowlers. You know, remember, that place was our home. And I remember Scott and Vito. I remember watching them get better. And I was down there. I was a kid, and they were even younger. So then when I was in my early 20s, they started to get into the 16, 17, 18-year-old range. In fact, the funny story about Vito, he might not know this, but I do. He subbed one night in the Montalbano's League, which is the scratch league on Thursday night. It was the big league. You remember it, right? A lot of good balls. Yeah, Joe knows. And Vito was an up-and-comer, and I think he might have shot, let's say, like 630-something. And so on the sheet, your average goes in on the bottom. Average, 214. He shot like 642 or something. So they used to call out on the loudspeaker, we need a sub 214. Is there a sub 214? Kid was like, right here, 214. Three games. That's my story. It's my story about Vito Collucci. And at the time, 214 was big, so he was moving right into an anchor spot for somebody. I'm 214.
He bowled against Frankie Grasso.
But you know what he wasn't shy about? Not me. So the bowling community wants to know some things from these two guys, newcomers to the draft league. We walk into a deli and we order a bagel. What kind of bagel are we ordering, Scott?
Everything.
Everything bagel? Butter, cream cheese?
Cream cheese. Scallion cream cheese, I think, is good.
There you go. How about you, Vito?
I gotta say the same thing. Everything cream cheese.
Okay, so everything is hot. How about it's later on in the day now? It's lunchtime. Cold cuts. Vito, what are we ordering? Your go-to sandwich.
Provolone.
Mustard? Just plain.
And oil and vinegar. Less tomatoes.
Okay. Scott?
Chicken cutlet palm, mozzarella. I don't know.
Hot peppers?
Yep. Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah. All right. So Scott's an eater. I like that. I had no idea, Scott. How about Ralph's Ices? People love it. They want to know.
Oh, yeah.
What are the bowlers ordering in the summertime when we go to Ralph's Ices? The line's long. Your turn. We walk up. Vito, what are we getting?
I got to tell you, traditional lemon.
Okay, so old school lemon like my father. Yeah. Scotty, you can say ice cream if you want.
I like the what do you call it, the blue cherry, the cherry lemon, and the blue one, blue ice.
We're talking about rainbow. We're talking about rainbow. Okay. How about Gino's rainbow at the pizza places? You used to know they had it with the little sign in the window. Remember? Right? Remember that little sign? Gino's rainbow was good. How about, let's go, favorite movie from Scott Walsh.
Well, it's going to be it's a good one.
It's okay.
Titanic.
Good movie. Vito. No Godfather, no Goodfellas.
Okay, no Godfather. Gatsby.
The Great Gatsby. Okay, all right, I got it. How about, are we binge-watching any TV shows currently? And if you are, I want the current one. And what is one of your favorite binge shows?
I don't have one. I guess.
Sopranos?
I don't watch that, no.
Vito?
I was recently watching, what's that movie called? Not Sopranos.
Jack Ryan?
Jack Ryan, actually. That was a good show.
All right, Jack Ryan was good. Scott?
The Honeymoon is Marathon.
That's great. That's great. Hey, look, we're going bowling, but we're not going bowling. Joe, right?
That's right. We're going bowling, but we're not going
bowling. Why don't you start with this? How are they going to know I'm a hurricane, Alice?
Just open your mouth.
Easy. Just open your mouth. Did we break any traffic laws on the way to the bowling center tonight? Scott?
Nope.
Vito, roll to a stop sign?
Maybe a little speed.
Wants to get here. What would you say? He takes a train. I'm going to tell you something about Scott. This kid, I remember him. You see him walking around the neighborhood. Hard worker, Scott Walsh. He's a grinder. I don't know about Vito, but Scott is a grinder. This kid works. And we'll also dedicate this to all the grinders out there. Anyone up before 6 a.m. this morning? Grinder. Joe, what else you got for these youngsters, Joe, before we get out there and start practicing?
What else we got for these guys? We want to know, are they bowling in the singles play? Are they bowling in
the... Where were you guys Saturday in Jim Elliott's New Year's Classic? Scott, you're always here. Where were you?
I was 7A.
You did bowl.
Oh, you did bowl.
Yeah,
what place are you in, third?
Nah, I didn't make the cut.
Fifth. Vito, did you bowl?
I did, but I didn't.
You're on the board, what? Fifth?
Not too good. No, no, no.
That's why we get free entries, fellas.
By the way, Saturday was indeed a disaster. I mean, wow. I think I was lower than all of you, to be honest with you. Talk about being lost. Woo! What a donation. You know what? Proud donation. And speaking of tournaments, the alumni battle was an excellent time. We did it on New Year's Eve, and Farrell High School topped McKee in a roll-off because after 15-game Baker format, tournament hosted by Mike Ruff and Frank Wilkinson, total pinfall landed on the pin, if you can imagine. And give me some of the winners. It was Rob D'Onofrio, Danny Dunleavy, Scotty Porto, Rob Tierney, and Gary Ricci. That's a hell of a team right there, if you think about it. They beat McKee Staten Island Tech, which was four powerhouses, John Rome, Jeff Charay, Jason Katz, and Mikey McNichol. It was a lot of fun. And I will say a shout-out to my teammates, which were Nick Antonucci, Nick Handog, and Southpaw Joe Labargo. We came in fourth, which is not bad considering Jeff put us on the B team. It's okay. We still love you. But at this point in the show, it's going to be the Lowe's Bowler of the Week. I don't know if you guys know this, but we dedicate to the lowest bowler of last week, wins a gift certificate from Lowe's Home Improvement. And the good news is that neither of you are in this envelope. 78 bowlers, somebody went real, real low. And that person is a former winner, but you know what? He is a good bowler. He's switching companies right now. He's blaming it on the ball manufacturer. I love that. They're going to switch now. We're going to go to Storm. The winner of the Lowe's Bowler of the Week is none other than Christian Ruiz, famous ball driller from next door, our sponsor, Country Pro Shop. Congrats, bro. 5-13, lighting it up, threw four or five strikes on the entire night. You got to love it. Joe, come on in and send these guys off.
Send them off. Fellas, I just want to say, Vito, thank you again. You were a good guest. Scott, thank you, bud. Thank you. So before we sign off, just a quick story. Last Monday night, our good friend, a friend of the show, a guest a few weeks ago, and a Staten Island Bowling Hall of Famer, our friend Kevin Rourke, he's sitting right around there somewhere. He's standing up over there now having a sip of soda. Chico's walking past him. Kevin Rourke, the guy lives here. His whole family works here, okay? Kevin's here all the time. Last Monday night, he forgot it was bowling night. His team actually had to text him. Kevin Legg called him and said, Kev, are you coming? And he's like, coming where? Coming bowling. We're ready to start. Kevin must have hit the pedal to the metal. I think he broke a few traffic laws coming here. But anyway, he made it in the third frame, and he had to catch up. And Kevin then had the nerve to say that he blamed his wife. Now, like most husbands do, Joe, we blame our wives. So, but I have to say, in this case, I'm going to defend Kevin's wife, the lovely Stephanie. It was not Stephanie's fault. He blamed Stephanie because she normally works here on Monday nights. Stephanie had the night off. So Kevin got totally thrown that it wasn't Monday. I don't know what night he thought it was. He didn't remember it was bowling night. So just to break his horns, I texted him on Saturday and said, hey, Kevin, it's Saturday. I texted him on Sunday. I said, hey, Kev, it's Sunday. You know what tomorrow is, right? And today about 4:45, I sent him a text. Hey, Kev, it's Monday. We're bowling later. I then came to find out Marco also texted him and said, hey, Kev, you doing anything later on tonight? Don't forget, it's Monday. We're bowling. Guy's a Hall of Famer. He forgets bowling night. We love him anyway. Anyway, folks, again, next week, our guest, another first-year bowler in the draft league, Andrew Shaw, young guy, bowled with my son up at Binghamton. He's in the draft league now, and we're going to have Andrew on as our guest next week as we continue the newbie theme on Live at the Draft League. And again, in closing, our deepest sympathy to Tommy, my boy, Malagreca, his family. We still can't believe Tommy's gone, but the bowling community lost a character, lost a good friend, but the bowling community gained an angel. Rest in peace, Tom. We love you. As we always sign off, good night, good luck, God bless, good bowling.